Hello viewers, welcome back to my channel. I am Neha Paryani and in today's session we are going to discuss about third chapter of macroeconomics, that is money and banking. Okay, and the topic that we are going to discuss today is money creation and money multiplier, right? So let's begin. So in order to understand how the money creation is done by commercial bank, first of all we should know what is meant by a commercial bank, right? So a commercial bank is the financial institution which performs the banking functions with the motive of earning profits. Now this is the main point. See, there can be many types of banks, like there is industrial bank which provides loans, loan facilities to the industrialist, right? And there can be agricultural banks which provide loan facilities to the agriculturist, farmers, right? Now commercial bank carries on the banking functions with the motive of earning profits. So the main motive of the commercial bank is to earn more and more profits, right? Now here another question arises. So what can be the functions of the bank, right? So let's discuss them now. The functions of a commercial bank are, first is accepting deposits. See, whenever we think of savings, we think of bank, right? We go to the bank and deposit our money into the bank, right? Now bank receives our money and it gives us some rate of interest in return, right? So the first function of a bank is to accept the deposits, okay? Next, granting loans. Now if I am in need of some financial help, then I will go to bank, right? So I can ask the financial help from the bank. So bank will grant me some loans and in return I will have to pay some rate of interest, right? So the second function is granting of loans. Guys, here I am explaining the functions of a commercial bank in very brief manner. If you want a detailed video on the functions of a bank, then its link will be provided below, okay? So you can check it out. So the first two functions can be considered as the primary functions of a commercial bank, okay? Third function is overdraft facility. So bank provides us overdraft facility on our current account. For example, if our deposits are rupees 1000 but I want to withdraw rupees 2000, then the bank will give me 1000 rupees extra in the form of overdraft, okay? So it can be treated as a short term loan given by the bank. Right. Next, fourth function is investment in government securities. So if we want to make any investment in any government security, so it will be done on behalf of us by the bank. Right. So again, this is the function of a commercial bank. Right. So there are certain terms that we need to understand before moving to the topic of money creation. Okay. And the first term is borrowing rate. What is the borrowing rate of a bank? See, the rate of interest offered by the banks to the deposit holders is known as borrowing rate. For example, I am an individual, okay? So I want to save my money and I am going to bank to deposit my money into the account, right? Now what the bank will do? Bank will receive that money from me, okay? Assume that I am depositing 1000 rupees into my bank account, okay? Now in return bank has to give me some rate of interest, right? Some interest it has to pay me at the year end, right? So assume that bank is giving me 6% as rate of interest per annum, okay? So now this 6% can be called as borrowing rate. So the rate which the bank offers to its deposit holders, it means that bank is offering me 6% on 1000 per annum, right? So this is what we call it as borrowing rate, okay? So this borrowing rate is not common for all the banks, okay? So it can also be 4% per annum or 3% per annum. It depends upon the banks, right? So the next term is lending rate. The rate of interest charged by the commercial banks for the loans given by them. Now assume that I am in need of some money and I am going to bank for some loan, okay? Now bank is giving me some loan, like BA is bank and BO is borrower, that is me, okay? And I am borrowing rupees 10,000 as loan from bank, okay? Now I have to pay certain amount as the interest to the bank. Okay, so assume that I am paying 12% per annum. Okay, now this 12% will be called as the lending rate, right? So in borrowing rate, bank will pay some amount as interest to its deposit holders, but in lending rate, bank will receive some amount as interest from its borrowers. Okay, I hope it's clear now. Third term is spread. The difference between lending rates and the borrowing rate is called spread. Now assume that I am an individual, I have deposited the money into the bank, right? And bank has received from the money from me, and then it has lent that money to its borrowers. Okay, so now bank is paying me, assume that 4% interest per annum, right? And bank is receiving 12% interest upon its loan, right? So here the difference between borrowing rate, that is 4 minus 12, right? So 8% will be the profit to the bank. So this is what we call it as spread. Okay, clear? And the last term is legal reserve ratio. Okay, after this we will discuss about money creation, right? So, the proportion of total deposits commercial banks must keep as reserve by law is called as legal reserve ratio. See, all the commercial banks have to keep certain percentage as reserves by them. Okay, so assume that the total deposits that the bank is receiving are rupees 1000 and the ratio, that is legal reserve ratio, can be 25%. Right, so now what the bank will have to do, bank will have to keep rupees 250 as reserve with it, and the remaining 750 can be given as loans to others. Okay, so this 25% is called as legal reserve ratio. Guys, I'm using 1000 as example in every case because then it will be easy for you to understand. Okay, now let us discuss about money creation by commercial banks. Here I'm using pen and paper so that I can show you practically. Okay, money creation of commercial banks start with the initial deposits of the bank. Okay, so this we need to remember, it starts with the initial deposits which is made by the customers into the bank. Okay, so for this example, let us assume the initial deposits of a bank is rupees 1000 and LRR is 20%. Okay, so as I told you earlier, LRR is legal reserve ratio, right? So 20% out of our initial deposit should be kept as reserves. Okay, so now let's find out what is 20% of 1000. So it is rupees 200, right? So when we deduct rupees 200 from 1000, we get balance of rupees 800, right? Now the banks can lend this 800 rupees to its borrowers. Okay, it cannot lend full 1000 rupees. So after deducting LRR, the remaining amount can be lent as the loan to the borrowers of the bank. Okay, so are you clear up to here? Now let's show this in a table. Okay, so this is round one. The initial deposits that the bank has were rupees 1000 and the LRR was 200 rupees, right? 20% of 1000 is 200, right? And the loan that can be given to the borrowers is rupees 800, right? So this is the first round. Now, here it is further given that let us assume that the entire commercial banking system is one single unit. Is a single unit. Okay, so this means that assume that we are depositing this 1000 rupees into SBI bank account, right? But SBI bank account, it may be SBI, it may be ICICI, it may be Canara Bank, it may be Axis Bank, it may be any bank. So all these are treated as one single unit in this process, right? So this is a very important point. Next. And all the transactions in the economy are routed through banks. So here the transactions in the economy are routed. Again, this is an important point. So what this means, see, assume that you are borrowing certain money from the bank. Okay, so this is bank and the person named A is borrowing this 800 rupees from the bank. Okay, next. So A is purchasing certain goods from a person called B. Okay, so A will make the payment, right? So A will make the payment of rupees 800 to B. Okay, now what B will do? B will deposit this money again into the bank. Okay, so this is called as routed transaction. So here the all the transactions are routed through bank. Okay, now what will happen? This 800 rupees will again come back to the bank as deposits, right? So in the second round, this 800 rupees has again come back as deposit to the bank. So 800 rupees, again we need to deduct LRR of 20% out of 800, right? So 20% of 800 would be rupees 160. Okay, so when we deduct 160 from 800, the remaining figure will be 640. Now again bank can give rupees 640 as loan to other persons. Okay, so again this process will continue. In the third round, bank has deposits of rupees 640. So again 20% of 640 would be rupees is 128. So when we deduct 128 from 640, we get 512 rupees, right? So this is the process of money creation. Now the question arises, up to how many times the bank can continue this process, right? So in order to understand this, we use the concept called money multiplier. Okay, so the formula for money multiplier is 1 divided by LRR. Okay, so in our example, the LRR is 20%. Right, so here instead of writing this percentage symbol, I am writing 20 here, okay, along with 1, right? So now it's 100 divided by 20. So when we divide it, we get the answer as 5. So it means that 5 times this process can be continued. 5 times in the sense, 5 times of initial deposits. Our initial deposits are rupees 1000 into 5. Right, so until our deposit reach rupees 5000, we can, or the bank can, continue this process. Okay, so again here it will be into 5 and into 5. So 200 into 5 would be rupees 1000 until the reserves reach to rupees 1000, and the loan 800 into 5 would be rupees 4000. Right, so up to 4000 loan can be given. Right, initially the bank started with the deposits of rupees 1000 rupees only. Now the bank has deposits of rupees 5000, right? So it means that 4000 rupees is extra, that is money created by the bank, right? So this is the process of money creation and money multiplier. I hope it's clear now. Okay guys, so this was all about today. If you found this helpful, please hit the like button. Also subscribe to my channel. Hope to see you in my next videos. Till that, happy learning.